and information. New sports.
From the beautiful Xanadu room at the Trump Taj Mahal Casino Resort in Atlantic City, Hard Knock Productions Incorporated, Louis Neglia, world kickboxing champion and executive director, and Paul J. Perina, executive producer, present Hard Knock 7. This program is promoted by Hard Knock Productions Incorporated, sanctioned by KICK, and under the jurisdiction of the New Jersey State Athletic Control Commission.
Welcome to Hard Knock 7. I'm Michael Clark. I'll do the blow-by-blow commentary with my partner doing the color, world championship kickboxer Lou Neglia, who is also the promoter and a matchmaker for Hard Knock 7, the event tonight. And Lou, a chance to see a major world champion, Joe Pina from Portugal, in an intercontinental lightweight challenge against David Hamilton from North Carolina.
Out with his right punch. Joe Pina, world champion, expects to stay that way. Although he's a national hero in Portugal, supposed to be a true superstar, he must make it in the United States, and he's here to prove that tonight.
And Hamilton is a man to prove it against. He's fought the best in the semi-main event. Irish Mike Ryan, fighting Irish Mike Ryan, will defend his United States kick super light heavyweight title against a bit of a surprise, Brad Morris, who we've mostly seen in martial arts films, kicking and punching.
Brad Morris surprised the martial arts community 2 months ago when he went to decision with the U.S. champ Mike Ryan. He's here to prove that was not a fluke. Mike Ryan, on the other hand, was very disappointed with his performance. He underestimated Brad, didn't train properly, and he expects a KO to prove that tonight. This is a grudge rematch and probably won't go the distance.
In a battle for the vacant kick United States middleweight title, will Caveman Carpenter, who is higher ranked, takes on the very popular Mike Sexton, popular because he has incredible power.
Mike Sexton, undefeated and with his great KO power, has moved quickly through the ranks and earned a shot tonight at the U.S. title. Will Carpenter, 22 wins and only 2 losses, and ranked number 3 in the world, defines his ability. This is a great matchup tonight.
Hard Knock 7 action when we return.
Sunday, April 2nd, World Kickboxing returns to the Trump Taj Mahal. It's a night of international championships as Hard Knock Productions presents Hard Knock 8, directed by world kickboxing champion Lou Neglia and Paul Perina. See U.S. world champion Vizio take on Portugal's world champion Joe Pina, and see Portugal's champions Soares, Moraes, Caneas, Nogueira, and Lemos battle U.S. champions Labrie, Ryan, Rivera, Nieves, and Sexton. Hard Knock 8, the world's greatest kickboxers. For tickets, stop by the Taj box office or call Ticketmaster at 1-800-736-1420.
We're back, Michael Clark with Lou Neglia. Tonight's bouts will be held under the sanction of KICK, the Karate International Council of Kickboxing. Lou, let's take a look at tonight's rules.
The rules for tonight are the mandatory 8 count, the standing 8 count is in effect, 3 knockdown rule is in effect, fighter cannot be saved by the bell except in the last round, no kick sweeps, all punches and kicks must be landed above the waist, no striking with the head, knee, or elbows, fighter must throw 8 kicks per round or 1 point deduction, the 10 point must scoring system is in effect.
Tail of the tape, except for age, these guys are pretty equal. Sexton, however, had to come up to 162 pounds. Carpenter had to come down a weight class or two to 165. Kick has allowed a weight allowance on this middleweight bout. Neither man at the 159 ordinarily required. And now let's go to Ed Therrien to introduce the fighters.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next bout is scheduled for 7 rounds, and it's the U.S. Middleweight Championship. Our referee is Jim Giorgiulo. Introducing first in the red corner, wearing the multicolor trim trunks. He weighed in at an even 165 pounds. Now this young man has 22 wins, 2 losses with 10 knockouts. From Columbus, Ohio, ladies and gentlemen, here is the challenger, Will Caveman Carpenter. Carpenter, and his opponent in the blue corner, wearing the black trunks with the gold trim. Now he weighed in at an even 162 pounds. This young man is undefeated in 12 pro bouts with one knockout. From Livingston, New Jersey, and fighting out of Brooklyn, New York, ladies and gentlemen, here is the champion, Mike, the Sandman Sexton.
All right, Mike Sexton, unbelievable knockout record, 11-0 with 10 KOs. He didn't get a KO in one fight, he says, against Paulino Pacheco because he fought with a broken hand that put him out for a year, a year and a half.
Protect yourselves at all times.
All right, Jim Gargiulo is the man in the middle. Will Carpenter says, sure, Sexton knocks people out, but he's never faced a guy of my size. He says he's the hardest hitting man in the division, Sexton. But he hasn't faced a man who's tough as I am, and he hasn't faced opponents with the kind of boxing skills to come in, spin away, hold you, grab you inside, turn you, take a step to the side. His opponents have come straight in and out. Caveman Carpenter says he will not do that.
He's an angle movement fighter, and he slips punches, and he will never walk into that right punch, he said.
Sexton says his corner has said they don't really know much about their opponent, but they heard he's a wild man who comes right at you. Carpenter said he is anything but.
Well, Mike Sexton also felt that he says the training that I'm doing is to perfect the techniques that I know I need to do against any opponent. And he does predict another knockout for his record.
And Sexton had a chance to allow Carpenter to sample the power in his legs. Known as a puncher, not a kicker until the last fight, Sexton scored a knockout with round kicks alternately left and right.
But Mike Sexton said he has killer kicks, knockout power kicks, but only the last fight he happened to draw one. Prior to that, he went to the body with those kicks and dropped the hands down to knock him out with his right punch.
And there's a weakness of Sexton right there. Carpenter finding the left and right hands up, open to the head. Sexton doesn't block much in his past fights.
And he did say he was going to do more defensive movement, but we didn't see it as of yet. And he also said he was going to improve his combinations and not throw one or two punches, but throw six, seven punch combinations. But again, it's early, Michael, only first round.
And Sexton is finding his opponent is not directly in front of him, is moving side to side, not always out of range, but not directly in front of him.
But definitely not walking into that right punch yet.
No, definitely not, but it takes a while. Sexton putting hands and feet together that time, chasing his man. And open again inside for the short right. Carpenter just measuring him, not loading up yet on those punches. Again, Carpenter wants to outpoint Sexton through the first few rounds and then make it difficult for him to be found. Left hook by Sexton was close.
Nice combination for Will Carpenter afterwards.
Sexton chasing behind the front kick. Carpenter taking a deep breath, getting some attention out.
Good strong punching combination.
Right hand to the chest by Sexton, finishes it off with a stronger punch. And early on, it looks like Sexton may be stronger, but Carpenter has the better moves end of round one.
Mike, in reference to the U.S. title, this means a great deal to Mike Sexton. He brought all his fans today, and he's dedicating this fight to his instructor, who was a former U.S. champion, and that's Tony Arnaud. First round, again, is just a feel-out round. Mike Sexton is not a strong starter, and in his previous fights, he's proved that also. But he gets better as it goes on.
And I think Carpenter is right. We have not seen Sexton in with an opponent of his ilk.
No question about it. You can tell, of course, that the Caveman is not the number three world-ranked fighter for nothing. He has great skills, and he's got great lateral movement, which is very important against a powerful puncher like Mike Sexton.
Well, Mike Sexton, a private eye, often does surveillance. He's going to have to chase down his man like a good detective tonight.
No question about it. He's got an interesting corner too, Mikey. That Tony Arnaud, the former U.S. welterweight champ, Fred Corazon, 4-3 black belt, the chief referee, and Dennis Murphy.
The River Wild.
Interest in Sexton's corner.
Nice combination.
Strong legs from Sexton. He is just a powerful, powerful man. Even if he's not the bigger fighter, he's the more powerful fighter.
And Mike, as you said, he has powerful powerful face kicks. He just never haven't used them that much in the past because he wants to work the body like a smart fighter would to bring a hands down for that right punch.
And that slip was unsettling to Sexton as he tripped on the bottom rope, not totally aware of where he was in the ring. So it's a little bit tense out there. Carpenter, tasting the power of those legs now, is a former quarterback and defensive back for Ohio University's football team.
He says he likes, of course, football, but he, again, enjoys the individual sport of kickboxing. He doesn't have to blame anybody else for a mistake. It all lies in his own hands. He trains for himself, and when he has a victory, it's himself. He doesn't have to worry about another fellow teammate messing up that victory for him.
Two big men. It is tense in there. Carpenter found an angle, but is still a little cautious about following up after he caught Sexton spinning with his back turn. Oh, look at that side kick. And Carpenter is mad that he came in straight into the side kick. That's not an angle he wants.
And that's definitely, again, you saw the frustration on his face doing what he said he wouldn't do, and that's come forward. And if he does that, Mike Sexton will find the mark.
And now Carpenter feels the need to get even, and Sexton likes the fact that his man is coming towards him. Sexton backing up, takes a light round kick. Sexton, the front kick, right hand over the top.
Good right punch over the top, and that's his famous punch that led to most of his 10 knockout victories of his only 11 fights.
Indeed, when he got the kick knockout, he was very conscious of trying to steal the clinic. A wild right hand, now a right hand inside by Sexton is better. And Carpenter with a good right hand inside off the ropes.
Good strong combination by Mark Sexton, that's what he's known for, his KO power. But a nice finish by the Caveman also. Good strong fight, good competitive fight. Both fighters, of course, have an extreme power.
And Sexton lifting his left leg nicely to the head that time. He gets good height on those kicks. And end of round two. Another hard fought but intelligent round.
Attention, homeowner.
All right, here comes Sexton. Ouch.
Seems like Mike's getting his confidence to get his offense going, and he's picking up the pace this third round.
Coming out behind kicks, which is a smart way to go. Sexton may have a scrape above his left cheek and a little swelling above his right eye. No, check it, left eye. Of course, his eyes were swelling last fight we saw him here. And swelling shut from the bottom up. This fight, he's taking less punishment.
No question about it. He's being a little more aggressive like he should. A nice strong roundhouse kick, but it was blocked by Carpenter.
And we had him behind against Panushik.
Until that explosive round.
That's it. Oh, there's a right hand, and Carpenter came right into it. And now Sexton seems to be handling Carpenter's angles with much more aplomb. And now legs strongly to the body by Sexton.
It seems like the Sandman is starting to find his mark, relax a little bit more, doing more offensive techniques.
Here comes Carpenter trying to get back into it, coming straight in though, behind his hands. It works for him, but he doesn't land a big shot. Inside, the uppercut still working. Sexton worked on trying to see and block the uppercut and hurt him last night.
No question about it. And he said he did a lot, many, many hours of defensive movements to improve some of the mistakes he made on Tom Panacek in the last fight.
Sexton's corner, Fred Corratone in particular, says the uppercut and legs up to the head from underneath will spell the knockout this time for Sexton. 10 knockouts in his 11 fights. Right hand over the top by Sexton.
Good, strong, powerful punch. And that's his main punch. Although he's got strong roundhouse kicks, that's his main punch. And once he finds a mark, he can mark out most opponents with that punch.
Sexton's eyes clear. He is all business in there. It is Carpenter who looks like he is the more defensive fighter if you check his eyes. Sexton trying to corner him now. Carpenter ducks nicely. Sexton behind the kick, but Carpenter with the jab. Double jab and ending strong that time, good. Will Carpenter.
Good strong combination at the end. And again, Mike Sexton is starting to find his mark. Starting to open up now. Usually the first rounds are negative to him, but they weren't bad this fight. They were close rounds, and now the pace is starting to pick up in the favor of Sexton. And the eyes of Caveman, he's too defensive, and he seems like he's shying a little bit away. You can't do that with Mike Sexton.
Absolutely not. This is the quickest start we've seen in Sexton. And
there's a little bit of bubble on Mike Sexton's left side above his eye, putting the onswell on it.
And there's a little red spot below the eye as well. And we look in the corner. Caveman Carpenter. Carpenter trained by Sam Jones. They know each other forever. Sam Jones, a pro kickboxer and a pro boxer, has a school, a karate school in Athens, Ohio, and they've hooked up as trainer and pupil in the last month. Sometimes when you change handlers in the middle of a career, you have a one or two fight adjustment. Wondering if Carpenter feels that now. Sexton at his quickest start as we've seen him in any of the Hard Knock series fights. He's been on most of them.
And I think he learned from the last fight with Panucci that he started a little bit too late.
They gave us a hard time, said, how could you have him behind early?
Well
he was. And they obviously learned from that because Sexton is fighting quickly. And Carpenter not able to put fight plan, and he thought he'd just waltz in, throw some quick hands, pile up an early lead, let Sexton eat his gloves for a while. Sexton says, no dice, I'm winning every round if I can win it.
Unless he's got something up his sleeve, Mike, I see Carpenter off his fight plan, too defensive against Mike Sexton.
He now has to attack, and he's not finding good angles to attack. He's not getting inside, able to spin and turn his man and punish him. His hands landed early, Carpenter. He's not had the same success the last two rounds.
And Mike feels it, and I think he's going to start opening up now. He's well focused for this fight here. Again, this is a dream come true fight for him, and he's going to stay and win it by his offense. Good strong.
Sexton prepares for his fight sparring with his trainer, Tony Arnaud, the former U.S. champion.
Talking about Tony Arnaud, it's a funny corner. Probably the first time the two corner men that are in Mike Sexton's corner or any corner ever fought each other. Tony Arnaud fought and won a decision against Dennis Murphy. Both corner men now for Mike Sexton.
As long as Murphy doesn't try to win it back during the fight.
I hope they don't find the corner. That's right.
All right. U.S. middleweight title kick sanction vacant, being fought out here above us. Seven-round fight, we're about midway through, and it has been smart and powerful action, but neither man yet to hurt the other. It's been some frustration with Styles, but so far nobody wobbled.
No question about it. Mike Sexton looks like he's getting on his mark, but...
Oh, slipping down after a good right round kick to the kidneys. Sexton, a gentleman, lets him fall and get up. Now Sexton trying to corner his man. And again, got to feel like Mike Sexton doing awfully well here in pursuit of his dream, the U.S. middleweight title.
Carpenter Mike, for sure, is definitely too defensive, and you can't win a fight on defense alone. Right now, the judges had to be giving the points to Mike Sexton and piling up points as these rounds go on.
I'll tell you, one of the things that's impressive, Lou, is Sexton's corner did not have a good line on Carpenter. All they had heard was that he was an aggressive and wild fighter, hence the nickname Caveman. And yet Sexton, fighting an entirely different style of fighter than the corner anticipated, doing very well.
You know, Mike Sexton, as you mentioned when we spoke to him, again, his fight plan is to, again, train hard, be offensive, and no matter who the opponent is, he will take that fight plan to it. He's confident about his KO power, and he'll always be an aggressive fighter. He has to be effective.
Above us, Mike Sexton in the gold and black with the stars and bars, fighting, I suppose, Carpenter in the caveman jokes. Carpenter says, oh, there's a right round kick to the head of Carpenter by Sexton.
Followed by a nice combination by Carpenter.
Carpenter getting his hands off faster now, not loading up, but looking to score some points. Oh, front kick to the head of Carpenter, and it looks like Carpenter might have nailed Sexton coming in on that.
Nice combination by Carpenter, but as you see, he's starting a little out of movement now, but he was going to stay stationary. That's definitely not the thing to do against a Mike Sexton.
Carpenter has to get busier. Sexton wants him in range and must welcome that.
And if he stays flat-footed, he'll be right in range for Mike Sexton's powerful kicks and punches.
Sexton says it makes it a little more exciting when you really don't know anything about your opponent. You have to see him. Left round kick was a good one by Sexton. He is lifting his legs quickly. Oh, and a hook punch.
Good strong hook punch by Mike Sexton.
And a slight wobble from Carpenter. Carpenter with new respect in his eye. Oh, right round kick to the body and then a left round kick low, says Carpenter, and he staggers a bit. Gargiulo waves Sexton back, and Sexton stops, winks at him, shakes gloves, and they'll go at it again. No official timeout there.
Unintentional, but definitely a low kick.
Carpenter now more like the caveman, but not a Neanderthal approach up till now. Oh, good jab by Sexton. Strong punchers need to throw the good jab first.
I've seen, again, a variety of powerful techniques from Mike Sexton. A hook punch, a stronger jab. Definitely did his homework, worked very hard for this fight, and it's showing in the ring now.
Sexton taking a deep breath and pursuing again. Oh, loaded up on the round kick and missed, but the left round kick gets into the gut. And a little dab of blood from the nose of Carpenter. Left jab again from Sexton, nailing the charging man.
Another stiff jab, and he's definitely getting comfortable in the ring, and that's what a fighter needs, so he can fluidly throw his combinations. Definitely another strong round for Mike Sexton.
End of round four.
Sunday, April 2nd, World Kickboxing returns to the Trump Taj Mahal. It's a night of international championships as Hard Knock Productions presents Hard Knock 8, directed by World Kickboxing Champion Lou Negley and Paul Farida. See U.S. World Champion Vizio take on Portugal's World Champion Joe Pena. And see Portugal's champions Soares, Moraes, Caneas, Nogueira, and Lemos battle U.S. champions Labrie, Ryan, Rivera, Nieves, and Sexton. Hard Knock 8, the world's greatest kickboxers. For tickets, stop by the Taj box office or call Ticketmaster at 1-800-736-1420.
They keep missing out. Those men over 50 who have symptomatic BPH, an enlargement of the prostate which causes urinary symptoms. Think about it. Does going to the bathroom keep you from getting a good night's sleep? Are you bothered by the frequent need to go? The feeling of urgency? Then the sensation that your bladder isn't completely empty? Now there's help. Read about it in this informative free brochure. Call toll-free now for your complimentary copy. It includes an important questionnaire for you to complete and discuss with your doctor. The brochure also offers information about BPH, its symptoms and treatment options. Urinary symptoms might also be...
To order your helpful free brochure, call 1-800-581-7300 now.
Rounds to go to determine a U.S. kick light heavyweight champion, excuse me, middleweight champion. And both men come out getting their kicks in.
Change of weight might have mixed you up, Mike. Both of them had to change weight for this fight.
That's right. Sexton coming up, Carpenter coming down. Nice round kick.
Another strong leap foot right house kick, followed by a side kick.
Sexton's feet, great dexterity. He has come a long way since breaking his hand against Pacheco, a fight he won and sitting out over a year. And he was very awkward, having to come back almost like he was relearning the sport. But boy, has he come on quickly. And now, after just 11 fights in his 12th fight, fighting and we think leading for the U.S. middleweight title.
Unofficially, I give him a big lead in this fight here for the aggression show in the last round.
Sexton hard to the head with the right round kick, and now the front kick and the right hand over the top. Buddy was ready for the right.
When a fighter starts getting comfortable, like Mike Sexton doing, he's free with his techniques, they come out faster, and he starts to find his mark. Definitely has found his mark on Will Carpenter.
Now he works the body of Carpenter.
Definitely flat for the 2-1 Carpenter.
Carpenter, a martial arts champion in the martial arts full contact continuous fighting sport, Bando, which is a Burmese art.
And his background in traditional martial arts is Taekwondo, with his instructor being Robert Quinn, and then kickboxing.
Left jab, and then the left round kick, left and left. I'll tell you, the array of combinations, Sexton's not putting four and five together, but he's throwing different combinations, hands and feet, almost every time.
No question about it. He said the big difference would be a lot more combinations in this fight here, and he's, of course, sticking to his fight plan.
Very impressive. The only information they had was that Carpenter was a very different kind of fighter than Sexton is seeing, but Sexton has become perhaps a true champion, a man who can adjust in the ring. And that's the end of round six. One round to go to determine the kick middleweight champion of the United States. All right, now, let me welcome Alan Goldberg. He is the editor of Action Martial Arts Magazine. Alan, you have had an awful lot of martial arts writing, all different disciplines in your magazine, but suddenly there's a lot of kickboxing.
Oh, yeah. Events like this is what's really making the mark on kickboxing. We've been out there covering events from the beginning of the inception of the magazine. And what's happening is all over, in nooks, crannies, everywhere you look, there's martial art kickboxing going on. Events like this, worldwide, it's happening.
So it's the increased activity that leads to increased coverage?
Oh yeah, 100%. We have events like this that we cover, and fighters from all over the world come to these things, and people see this, and that's the building of the kickboxing.
Alan Goldberg, thank you. We'll look for the next issue of Action Martial Arts Magazine.
Thank you.
Now, round seven, the final round for the U.S. kick middleweight title.
And Mike Sexton's fans are feeling that victory and that championship in their hand.
And if Sexton is smart, he won't get cute, and spoil his, he'll spoil his knockout streak if he has to and take home the victory. That was a good left round kick to the head of Carpenter.
Knowing the warrior Mike Sexton is, he's not going to lay back this round, even though he can and do defensive movement. He can stick to his offensive plan.
Just don't reach with that right hand, huh? Oh, left and a right over the top now for Carpenter. The left hand up was a good one, and the right hand over the top almost as good.
Probably the best punch of the night for Carpenter, that uppercut punch. That was the punch that Fred Corstone said Mike Sexton was going to effectively win his fight with.
Right hand by Sexton as Carpenter came in off the top of the head. Carpenter called the caveman by his dentist receptionist because of his forehead. Oh!
Good strong body attack.
Round kick. And Carpenter nodded, yes, you did it. You hurt me. Grudging respect in the last round of a title fight.
He wants his title. This is his dream come true, and Mike Sexton's going right after it.
That's it, the dream, the title he dreamed about most, U.S. champion. When he began in the sport, it's been a quick rise, fueled by extraordinary power. He's in against a man, it's been hard to budge Carpenter, but he has punished him. Left round kick to the body.
Strong body attack, strong body attack.
If this was a 9-10 rounder, he might get the knockout. Great spin technique.
No question. Great spin technique by Mike Sexton. He got power in his hands. He got power in his feet. He's a great fighter.
Right hand inside was open that time for Sexton. And he landed it.
And his fans sensed the victory, Mike.
Sexton pushing the man off of him. Stronger man who's fought at one and two divisions higher. And it's over. Seven rounds to decide now the U.S. kick. Middleweight championship.
Unofficially, Mike, this is a clear-cut victory for Mike Sexton. Took the fight to his opponent and won the championship and took it by his aggressive, powerful punches and kicks. This was, again, Mike Sexton's test and fighting a Frank fighter who's number three in the world.
All right, let's look at some of that terrific action to close this fight out.
Probably the strongest punch of the night for Carpenter, a strong right uppercut punch.
And that was the first time, Lou, that Carpenter showed that Sexton really hurt him.
No question about it. And definitely he felt the power of the Sandman throughout the night, because he got scored with backhands, right punches, left hook, roundhouse kicks to the body. A very strong performance from Mike Sexton.
You're looking at the Mid-Atlantic Championship belt there held over Sexton's head. One here at the Hard Knock Arenas here in the Trump Taj Mahal, and that qualified him for the U.S. title shot.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Trump Taj Mahal, we've got the scoring, and here it is. Judge Professor James Powers scores 70-65.
I know that.
While Judge Joe Gebby, he observed 70-63. And Judge Ralph Rispoli, he has it at 70-66. For the winner, by unanimous decision, and still the U.S. middleweight champion, Mike the Sandman Sexton.
Mike Sexton is the new kick U.S. middleweight champion. Mike Sexton, who is a private in private life, had to turn detective and search out a moving opponent early, pile up a lead early, something we've not seen him do, and it pays off as he punishes Carpenter and becomes the U.S. champion. Presents the U.S.